5 are reported injured after a magnitude 6.4 quake struck Calayan in Cagayan Tuesday night. The Office of Civil Defense says the victims sustained injuries after a wall collapsed on them. Local authorities have reported minor infrastructure damage.
Doon sa island municipality natin sa Calayan, may dalawang barangay ang reported incident. Sa isang barangay, dalawang bahay yung nasira. Then yung sa part ng sentro Calayan, may isang pamilya ang medyo nadiskrasya. Hindi naman malala, mga pasa-pasa lang. Dalawang bata at mag-asawa. Sagsagan ho siguro nung pagyanig na rattle yung pamilya, nagkanda bumbunggo sila.
Classes in Calayan Town remain suspended due to the quake. The Philippine Migrant Workers Department says there are no reports yet of Filipinos affected by the flooding in Libya, but the agency says it continues to monitor the situation there. The DMW adds it is ready to send help to Libya if needed.
The catastrophic floods happened in the Derna region, which is in the eastern part of Libya, the border of Egypt, near the border to Egypt, and most of the Filipinos in Libya are on the western side, the Tripoli side. We still are in touch with the Filipino community there and the DFA there.
The DMW also says there are also no reports of overseas Filipino workers affected by the deadly quake in Morocco.
We are sending basic necessities in tandem with the Philippine Embassy in Rabat, Ambassador Baha, basic needs and necessities down to the OFWs who need it. We continue to monitor the situation and we hope that no Filipinos indeed will be affected and no further Moroccan citizens will be affected.
In Libya, where more than 5,000 are presumed dead, well, at least 10,000 more are missing following a brutal storm. Storm Daniel caused dams to burst and triggered massive flooding that wiped out whole neighborhoods. So far, more than 1,000 bodies have been recovered in Derna alone, and officials expect the death toll to rise even further. The situation in the city is grim, with hospitals no longer operating and bodies left on sidewalks with morgues already full.
The head of the National Unity Government began directly supervising all the work of the teams formed by the government emergency team around the clock. The cabinet declared general mourning throughout the state of Libya to mourn the lives of the victims. The cabinet directed the mobilization of convoys of machinery and equipment for opening paths, withdrawing water and ambulance services towards the affected area in the eastern region.
Aid pouring into Libya. Turkey has sent more than 100 personnel to help in the search and rescue efforts. It also sent hundreds of tents, generators, and food packages. The United Arab Emirates also extending aid with shipments of food and medical supplies. The World Food Program, meanwhile, says it's ready to provide food to 5,000 families affected by the flooding.
The scale of it is unclear, but we know it's big and we know it's going to take a massive response. So in that sense, the World Food Program is prepared to respond. We have food in the warehouse in Benghazi. We're ready to deploy that quickly and rapidly as soon as we understand where the most needs are, who are the communities that are most impacted and in the most desperate need, and move that out as quickly as possible.
Over in Morocco, the death toll from Friday's quake nears the 3,000 mark. The number of injured has more than doubled to over 5,500. There's still no estimate as to how many more are missing. Hopes for finding survivors fading, with many traditional mud brick homes reduced to rubble in remote areas. The International Federation of the Red Cross and Red Crescent Societies, meanwhile, launched an emergency appeal to raise over $100 million to support quake victims.
In this appeal, we are seeking 100 million Swiss francs to be able to deliver on the most pressing needs at this time, which include health, water, sanitation and hygiene, shelter, relief items and basic needs, support to livelihoods, protection, and community engagement. we need to make sure that we avoid a second wave of disaster. This emergency response, as with many earthquakes, is a marathon. The people affected by the earthquake will need support for the weeks and months to come. And we will need to continue to show that solidarity and support, not only now, but in the future.
The magnitude 6.8 quake was Morocco's deadliest since 1960 and its most powerful in more than a century. The West warning Russia over a possible arms deal with North Korea. During the UN Security Council meeting, the U.S. and the U.K. slammed Russia for turning to North Korea for help in its war in Ukraine. North Korean leader Kim Jong-un is currently in Russia to meet with President Vladimir Putin. The two countries earlier denied that Pyongyang would supply weapons to Moscow.
We will continue to identify, expose, and counter Russia's attempts to acquire military equipment from the DPRK or any other state that is prepared to support Russia's war against Ukraine. We urge the DPRK to cease its efforts to transfer arms to Russia. We also urge all member states to remind Russia of its Security Council obligations, remind Russia that any transfer of arms between the two countries would violate UN arms embargo on the DPRK that Russia itself has voted to adopt.
The U.S. House of Representatives launching an impeachment inquiry into President Joe Biden over allegations he benefited from his son's questionable foreign business dealings. House Speaker Kevin McCarthy said the inquiry will focus on allegations of abuse of power, obstruction, and corruption. More in this report.
After months of investigations, House Republican committees will now pursue an impeachment inquiry into U.S. President Joe Biden.
Through our investigations, we have found that President Biden did lie to the American people about his own knowledge of his family's foreign business dealings.
McCarthy's announcement comes after months of pressure from House conservatives.
And I think that any other citizen that had stacked up against him what the president had stacked up against him right now would already be in court.
Democrats say Republicans have failed to turn up any evidence of Biden's supposed wrongdoing after months of investigation, in which tens of thousands of documents were turned over to investigators.
The impeachment inquiry is absurd. The American people want us to do something that will make their lives better, not go off on these chases and witch hunts.
Republicans hold a very slim majority in the U.S. House of Representatives, with just a 5-seat majority over Democrats.
I think it's also possible that those impeachment articles may never reach the Senate. With a slim majority, it's not clear that Republicans can get it across the finish line. They certainly cannot count on any support from Democrats. And so they really have to hold together every one of their members. And if they lose just five of them, they won't be able to pass it.
Some Republicans have expressed concern about pursuing an impeachment inquiry heading into the 2024 election year. Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell, who has said in the past that impeachments should be a rare process, declined comment Tuesday.
We got our hands full here trying to get through the appropriations process.
The announcement of the inquiry also sets up a showdown between Capitol Hill and the White House, as lawmakers must strike a deal with Biden to keep the government open past a September 30th funding deadline. If there is a government shutdown, House committees would be unable to work on an impeachment inquiry. Catherine Gibson, VOA News.
A constitutional law professor, meanwhile, says impeachment in the U.S. is becoming a prevalent political tool that sends the country towards a slippery democratic slope. Tulane University's professor Stephen Griffin calls the impeachment inquiry a horrible distraction for lawmakers who are faced with a September 30 deadline to avert a government shutdown.
Some of us are distressed about this because we thought the lesson of the Nixon impeachment that wasn't really adhered to in the Clinton impeachment was it really the level of seriousness of the allegations really has to be at a high level before you go forward. But now it looks like we're involved in a tit for tat situation where the parties feel that any effort against a president of their own has to be, in effect, paid back. There has to be payback. And that's a really bad situation for any democracy to be in, because it could obviously just spiral out of control. Every president is going to be subject to impeachment. That's not a good look for us. And it's also a horrible policy distraction.